Now the problem, let's get into kind of what the issue is, and if we look at the standard American diet or modern westernized diets, we know that we're derailing this homeostasis by consuming excessive amounts, specifically of refined carbohydrates. So if we consume excessive amounts of refined carbohydrates, what we're doing is increasing our blood sugar levels over and over and over again, and asking the pancreas to release insulin over and over and over again, and continuing to dump insulin into the bloodstream over and over and over again on a chronic basis, starts to break this entire mechanism down. And we no longer have homeostasis being maintained. That whole entire system starts to break down and not work properly, and we start to develop a condition referred to as hyperinsulinemia. And what that stands for, hyper means too much. Insulin is the hormone we discussed earlier, insulin that's released by the pancreas to lower blood sugar levels. And emia is in the bloodstream. So it's too much insulin in the bloodstream. That's what hyperinsulinemia refers to. And aside from being just a long, fancy, scary-looking word, it's actually a really scary condition that has been well documented as being a root cause of pretty much every major chronic disease that our society is currently facing. Specifically, some other kind of scary terms, obesity, Alzheimer's disease, cancer, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease. And again, those are fairly complex scenarios within the body as far as what's causing those things. But we do know that when they're present, hyperinsulinemia is oftentimes also present, more so than oftentimes. It's a very strong correlation between hyperinsulinemia and each one of these. And regardless of the mechanism of exactly what's causing these conditions, we do know that if we can strip away this as being the root cause through proper nutrition and diet practices, we're eliminating a huge potential portion of that problem. I mean, that's completely within our control to do that. And so that's kind of where the conversation starts, as far as really understanding on a kind of epidemic scale the situation that this currently is that our country is currently facing, that the world is currently facing. And now we need to start to understand what the solution is going to be on an individual level and how that can ultimately affect change.